you can go ahead and start pedaling. We're gonna do a warm up for 2 minutes.
There you go. How does that feel? Does it feel a bit too tight or does it feel good? Feel good? All right, awesome.
Whenever you feel like that you want to pull, just go ahead and give me everything you got and just look straight ahead whenever you go, all right?
For ready, middle school students.
You can go ahead whenever you're ready. Go ahead and there you go. Come on, pull.
It turns out a little exercise goes a long way in preventing disease, and the benefits of exercise are realized pretty quickly.
All right, try not to hold on. There you go.
And we think this leaves a great impression with the kids because they learn through very sophisticated research level testing how they compare with what is recommended for body fat and for fitness.
Awesome job. There you go. Keep that pace.
Those are some of the findings of new research from the Appalachian State University Human Performance Lab at the North Carolina Research Campus.
One, go Austin, go. Push.
Those benefits include reduced body fat, increased muscle strength, and a reduced risk of diseases like diabetes and cardiovascular disease.
If you want to feel like you want to start jogging, feel free to, okay? There you go.
Caleb Douglas is the quarterback of the Rockingham Middle School Raiders. He and some of his teammates at their Richmond County school are having their physical fitness levels evaluated. Richmond is one of four high schools in the state whose students took part in the fitness study.
Now, looking at this, I mean, it looks like you're in pretty good shape here. What have you learned, or what are you going to work on?
Well, I'm working on a treadmill and my sustained power. And my aerobotic power. So I want to be above average in everything.
So you're strong, but you got to work on your endurance, I guess.
Uh-huh.
It's called the Biomoto Program. The program is run for 2 years. About 500 students, boys and girls, have participated. The students' average age is 13. Researchers use a variety of tests to measure body composition, muscle strength, and aerobic and anaerobic fitness. Students are tested at the beginning of the school year.
You can see what your strength is and your body fat and can help yourself get better.
Those same students are then retested at the end of the year. In between, students are taught concepts that promote an understanding of science, technology, engineering, and mathematics combined with physical fitness.
So what'd you take out of this?
It was a good experience to get to learn all the stuff about my body and how much body percent and my endurance and everything.
You're sweating, I noticed. So
yes,
must
sir.
Be working.
Yeah, it's pretty hard.
Well, I was going to say, surprising how hard it was, or?
The treadmill was pretty hard. I'd have to say that's probably the hardest thing.
It'll also kind of increase their awareness for health science. You know, how exactly to live healthier, eat healthier, what impact, the education, learning about exercise and how to compound that with your daily intake of, you know, nutrients will allow them to be, you know, healthier adults moving forward.
Researchers found nearly half of the boys and 4 in 10 girls were classified as overweight or obese, following the body mass index guidelines published by the Federal Centers for Disease Control.
Everything goes south as they increase their body fat.
The higher the child's body fat, the less fit they were, aerobically and anaerobically. Thus, obesity, even at a young age, impacts health and well-being.
Your power, your strength, everything is very poor. And it's really upsetting to see this.
When I increase it, I'm going to show you this chart.
But here's the good news. The study also showed that over the course of the program and the school year, follow-up tests found a reduction in body fat and improved indicators of strength and physical health. Children with properly supervised physical activity can improve their health, and they are more likely to continue a healthy lifestyle when they see the benefits.
The number one reason everybody gives is lack of time. That they don't have the time, but people make time for what they think is important. And I think with these kids, if we can lead them to think it's important, that they'll put in the time.
It's recommended that middle school students get 60 minutes of exercise per day. 30 minutes of exercise is recommended for adults. But Dr. Nieman is quick to point out that exercise doesn't have to be done all at once.
But that can be added up just like change, you know, a dime here, a quarter there, and add up to a dollar. And that's what it is just putting in the 60 minutes throughout the day. That isn't a whole lot.